Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you are all well at your home. So welcome to Sonika's class. What we are going to start today, it is actually we have already started French Revolution chapter if you have seen the last video. In last video we discussed the event of 14th July 1789, the storming of Bastille, right? And it was, I told you that it was a flashback. Now we are going to start with the main content, that why that event took place. Okay, so let us get started. So before we start with that, first let us have a quick review of the king. Let us see quickly that who was king and his background. So King Louis XVI, he became the king in 1774. Okay, that event we read in 1789 and he became king in 1774, Louis XVI. Okay, Louis XVI was from Bourbon family. Now Bourbon biscuit, which you eat, Bourbon biscuit, chocolate biscuit, all are very popular amongst kids. So these biscuits, they have their origin in France. Okay, so from he was from that family, Bourbon family. On his, that family's name only that Bourbon biscuit brand is there. That time he was 20 years old when he ascended the throne of France. Married to Austrian princess Mary Antoinette. Now Austrian means many a time children get confused between Austria and Australia, and they think as Austria as Australia only. Okay, but no, it is not so. Austria is a country which is neighbor to France. It is in Europe only. Okay, so King Louis XVI married to the princess of Austria whose name was Mary Antoinette. Here I will read about her also late in the chapter. Upon his accession, he found an empty treasury. Now, when he became the king, now when we think about king system and monarchy system and all, you might have seen in TVs, okay? So, kings always had their treasury, hai na, khazana and all, where it was always loaded with gold, coins, etc., hai na, jewelry, gold, then stones, gems, etc. But when King Louis became the king, he found empty treasury. Now, what was the reason to it? This reason also we will see in the next video. Okay, so this is just, I have given you the background regarding King Louis XVI. Okay, now we will see the French society during late 18th century. Now what is the century system? Many a time children get confused when children we talk about 18th century. 18th century does not mean that years are starting from 1801 or 1802. We cannot call these years 1801, 2 or 13, 14, whatever. We cannot call that as 18th century. This is 19th century. Okay. So 18th century means when we are talking the years from starting from 1701 to 1799. Okay. I hope it is clear. When we are now talking about 18th century means when we are talking the years starting from 1701 to 1799. Clear? So now we are saying late 18th century. Late 18th century means you can say in 1780s, hai na, 1790s. Okay, so French society, how the structure of the society was. Now if we say Indian society in the ancient period, there were varna system, hai na, Hindus, Brahmins, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra and all, Brahmins ruled the society, all that. So here also we'll see in French society what was the structure. First, feudal society. Feudal society, what is the meaning of feudal system? Feudal system is such a system. In feudal system, there are people, those who are the landowners. Okay, landowners have huge pieces of land. Okay, they have vast lands and then they give that land to the landless laborers, or you can say to the peasants, those who don't have their own land. Okay, and then in return, these peasants, they pay rent to the landowner. Okay, it means landowner is there, he has, or he has a huge piece of land, but they are so rich, they don't work on that land, but instead they give that land on rent to the peasants, those who don't have their own land, and in return, they get rent from the peasants. Okay, this is the feudal system. old regime before 1789. Now, French society before 1789 was called as the old regime. One more question, many a times it is asked in the examinations that what do you mean by old regime? Okay, old regime is what? French society and its institutions before 1789. Okay, I hope this much is clear to you. Feudal society and old regime, both are clear to you. So, if you have any doubt and queries, then you can ask regarding this both later. Now, let us focus on how was the society? First estate, second estate, and third estate. Now, as in India, we had four varnas in ancient period: Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. Even in medieval, it continued during the colonial period as well. Okay, so there we had three estates. Estates mean three groups. First estate was clergy, second was nobility, third was the group where we had different kinds of people like peasants, merchants, and laborers. What was clergy? Clergy means these are the members of church. Like in India, Brahmins, they made rules of religion, right? Brahmins, we can here talk about the Purohits in Indian system, right? They made rules for people that caste rules and all. But there in France, we had clergy means the fathers, right? You might have seen in movies, English movies, sometimes there are fathers, you know, those who own church, right? So first estate was clergy. Second was nobility. Nobility means again those here we talk about the king's family, king's relatives, you know, all those people, those who were on high positions in the kingdom. Okay, so these two estates, they enjoyed privileges on the basis of their birth. Privileges kya hote hain baba? Privileges are the special rights. Okay, special rights on the basis of birth means those rights which you just get being born into that estate. Okay, for example, if I am born into any clergy family, I will get all those special rights which that clergy estate gets, right? So what was that privilege? First, the most important was exemption from paying taxes. Okay, so they did not have to pay any kind of tax. Now, clergy and nobility, these both were very rich. Okay, both were rich, but their privilege was they were exempted from paying taxes. How unfair it was, right? They were rich and they only did not have to pay any tax. Now, the third estate where we see, it was made up of mostly the poor people, peasants, landless laborers, merchants, laborers, potters, barbers, etc. They were obliged to pay taxes and render services. Now, all the taxes in state, they were paid by these poor people. They had to pay taxes, first taxes and then services. Taxes, so we understand what are taxes, means revenues. Services means render services means they also had to work at the homes of these first and second estate or in their farms, etc. In any type of services, they have to pay. Okay, and they only had to pay the taxes. Okay, I hope you have understood the situation in French society, how unfair it was. All those who were rich means the people of first and second estate, clergy and nobility, they did not have to pay any tax, though they were very rich, they could pay taxes. But third estate, they were very poor. They only had to pay all the taxes in spite of being so poor, right? So this was the French society. Now I hope you would be able to connect that why people hated king, right? Why the storming of Bastille took place means little bit idea you might be now getting, and these ideas will become clear in the further videos. Now, what were the major taxes paid by the French people of, or you can say by the third estate? First was tithes, tithes, tithes. Tithe was a tax which was levied by church. Means this tax people had to pay to church. Okay, church was used to collect this church tax, which was 1/10 of the total produce. Here produce is agricultural produce. Okay, for example, I have produced 100 kgs of wheat or whatever crop what I grow. So 10% of that means 10 kg of wheat I have to pay as tax, okay, to the church. This was Okay, so that was owned by church. Now you think church clergy members, they were already rich, they did not have to pay taxes, and one more advantage, they were collecting taxes, right? And second tax was tally. Tally was a tax which was paid directly to the state. State here by we mean government, means to the nobility or to the king, right? So this tax was collected directly by the state or by the government or by the king, right? So this is the whole scene. In this video, we'll just see this, focus on this much only, the French society. First, second and third estate. First and second estate enjoyed privileges of exemption from paying taxes. Third estate, those who were poor, peasants, merchants and laborers, they were obliged to pay taxes and render services to the first two estates. What were the two taxes paid? Tithes and tallies. Tithes, 1/10 of the agricultural produce to be paid to the church. Tally was to be paid directly to the state. Okay, then we have also seen a little bit about King Louis, which family he was from, Bourbon family, your favorite biscuits. When he ascended the throne, he was 20 years old, married to Queen Princess Mary Antoinette from Austria, and when he ascended the throne, he found empty treasury. We'll see the reasons in next video. I hope you have understood this much concept. So everyone must write these notes in their notebooks, and we have here answered few very short and one long question. Long question is directly asked on this topic. Explain the French society during late 18th century. Okay, so there you can explain this whole, whatever is discussed in this video. You can also jot down notes by taking a screenshot of the video. Then very short questions are, which family king was from? You will write Bourbon family. When did King Louis ascend the throne? 1774. Name the princess whom he married. Marie Antoinette, right? Then you can have, what was the special privilege of first and second estate? You will write exemption from paying taxes. Then you can have very short questions on defining taxes. What were tithes or what was tally? All this, okay? So I hope I have made it very clear that what kind of questions will be asked from this topic, long as well as very short, okay? So till the time I don't upload the next video, you work on this, write down the notes, question answers, and if you have any queries, please feel free to ask. Till the time, take care, have a good day.